Hi friends. So in order to have our Java Cloud service running, the first thing which we have to do is we have to create a database instance which will be used by our WebLogic instance Java as a service. So the first thing is you have to log in into your console. Then you can click on these three buttons which are here. Navigation menu, click on it, go to services, go to database, click on database, and then it will take you to the database cloud service. So here you will be able to create your instance. If you already have some instance, it will be show up here only. So right now we don't have any instances, so we'll go and click on the instance and we'll click on create instance. So we will be going ahead and creating a database instance which we will use for our Java application server. So instance name, you can give any instance whatever name you want. Description, you can give DB for Java as a service. Okay, so I've given SS technical region. I can give in which region do you want to have your database up and running. So I've given some. So here there are different version of DB which you can use. Even ADNC is also available. So for us, we will use Oracle Database 12c release 1. And enterprise edition, you can also select standard, enterprise high performance and extreme performance based on your requirement. If you are setting up a dev environment, then in that case you can select enterprise edition. If you are setting up a test or instances, then you can select extreme performance and high performance based on your requirement. Here you can see a database clustering with rack, database data guard standby for hybrid DR. Even you have lot of things can be done. So all these are depends upon the usage, which type of environment you are going to create. You can select. For us, for this demo, I have selected Oracle Database 12c release 1 enterprise edition, and it is a single instance. I don't want to create a hybrid one which will consume more CPU. So here I have to give the details about my database. Like whenever you create your database, you have to give the database ID, you have to give the pluggable database name, you have to give the sys and system username and password, how much space do you want to give, how much compute SIP you want to give, one CPU, 7.5 GB RAM and OC4, two CPUs or 15 GB RAM. So all these information you have to give it here. So right now let me give the DB name as SOA1. I just want to give SOA1. Now give the password. So you can give the password as it should have 8 characters to 30 characters with one upper and lower case and one special character. So there are restrictions which you have to follow in order to give this password. So I will just give welcome 123. So I've given this password. So I will just change this storage to 15 because otherwise it will charge me more. I will select the compute size as one CPU and 7.5 GB RAM. And based on your requirement, if you are setting up here, you can select higher configuration as well. And so let me WELCOM 123456 hash. So you put that. So now here you can you have to give for the backup and recovery. So you will give the name of the name where our backup will be created for our database. We have to give the username and password. Let me just give. So I've given the password, create the cloud storage container, and it will be so these are the information which you have to provide. These are the bare minimal details which you have to provide. If you select this high performance storage, then it will use a high performance storage for your DB, and it will start charging. There are some advanced settings as well. So the listen port will be 1521. If you want to change it, you want to customize it, you can do. Time zone will be UTC. Character set is AL32 UTF-8. National character set. It's depend upon you. If you want to change, you can change it. There are so many options based on your requirements. You can change it, but I will keep it all standard. Enable Oracle Golden Gate. Golden Gate is used for replication purpose to your database. So if you want to enable it, you can select this here only, and then while creating the database, it will enable Oracle Gate as well. All these things requires it will be chargeable. So make sure that whatever you are selecting will be charged. And then IP reservation, if you want to give some specific IPs, you can select here. I don't have anything. You can just select next, and it will show you the configuration summary, and then you have to wait for SSH key value. Okay, so I have to give the SSH key here as well. So the key which we have created, or I can just give the key values. I have this public key. I can just open, and let me just copy and give it here. So I've given my SSH public key here, and you can also select the public key which you have created. You just have to press next. Will give you the summary page, the value into it's something is wrong. Let me just make the changes again. So I have changed the passwords. So now let me just select next and see if each of the values which I provided is correct. If everything is correct, then it will go take me to the summary page, and on that summary page, so yeah, so confirmation. So it is showing me the confirmation page. All the details which I have selected is being shown here, and then I just need to click on create. So once I click on create, my DB will be created, and it will take another 10 to 15 minutes to get this DB up and running. So just let me just show you. I will just click on create, and the command will go to the Oracle Cloud, and then it will start creating this particular instance for me, database instance. So it will take another 10 to 15 minutes to get this instance up and running. So you can see it is creating instance. Once we come back after 10 to 15 minutes, then we will be able to see that this particular instance will be up and running. So I will come back on this page once the instance is created. So it's still creating the instance. You can see still creating instance. It took around, it's more than 10 to 15 minutes now. So it may take around 10, 15, 30 minutes based on the conditions. So there are many factors which comes in. So it will take around, so we'll wait for some more time so that this database instance gets created. So my instance has been created now. Database instance, you can see that it took a lot of time for the instance to get created. I have given the instance creation at 8:07, and at 9:21:51 AM UTC, the activity got ended. It may be because there may be a lot of requests today. Maybe a lot of people are using Oracle Cloud today, or because we have maybe because we are using a free version of this, so that may be the reason it took a lot of time. But yeah, it may take around half to 30 to 40 minutes of your time for getting this instance created. So all the information about this instance are here. You can click on the instance, and you can see this is the IP address, this is the SID, memory, storage, the all the information about this. So we'll make use of this we'll make use of this particular database when we are configuring our Java as a service. Thank you.